Hi children, today we are starting our class 10 topic. First chapter is chemical reactions and equations. Chemical equations and reactions. And in this chapter, first of all we will see what is a chemical reaction. Okay, so let's moving to the topic chemical reactions. We have already studied in the previous chapters or previous classes. There are two types of changes around us, physical and chemical changes. We are classifying the changes around us into two, physical and chemical changes. And at that time we have already studied that chemical changes are changes which are occurring permanently. And in that change, new substances are produced there, and these changes are permanent changes. Both the properties of physical and chemical properties of the material which are undergoing change, that material's physical and chemical properties will be changing them. So let us moving to the topic chemical changes. Chemical changes. Chemical changes, as we studied already, we can see that chemical changes are irreversible. Irreversible changes, new substances are produced. New substances are produced. Sometimes it will be one new substance or more than one new will be produced there. And this, in this case, both physical as well as chemical properties of the materials will change. Physical and chemical properties will be changing there. Okay, such a change we are calling it as a chemical change. For example, if you are burning a piece of paper, which you have studied in smaller classes as the example of a chemical change. When we are burning a paper, at that time, new material, which is ash, will be obtained there after burning, and the entire properties of that paper will be changing there. After the burning process, we are getting a new material which do not have any property, which does not have any properties of the previously existing paper. So new materials are producing, the properties are completely changing, and we cannot reverse it back to its original form. These changes we are calling it as the chemical changes. Digestion of food, cooking of food, all these are rusting of iron, all these are chemical changes. And we can say that these chemical changes are chemical reactions. All these chemical changes are chemical reactions. The change is happening because it is undergoing some reactions there. That is, because of that change, because of that reaction, it is undergoing that change, and due to that reaction, new materials are produced there. So we can say that this chemical changes, also known as chemical reactions. Chemical changes are also known as chemical reactions. So in this case, what we are actually calling the chemical reactions, it is another mode of chemical reaction, another expression of chemical changes. These chemical reactions are other expressions of chemical changes. So nothing new is the, due to that chemical change, that chemical reactions are happening, or due to that chemical reaction, that chemical change is happening. So how can we say that a chemical change has happened or not? For that, there are some observations. Some cases, more than one observation is available there. But in many cases, only one observation will be there. And whatever it is, the given observations, among the given observations, any one is present there, then we can clearly tell that a chemical reaction has taken place there in that particular situation. So we can see that, how can we say that a chemical reaction has taken place? So first of all, if you want to tell that a chemical reaction has taken place there, sometimes there will be a change in color. Change in color. Sometimes there will be a change in color. For that, we can see one example. Okay. At that time, we can see one example, change in color. For this case, we can already see, we can see a familiar example which you have already seen in different classes. If you are dropping an iron nail, if you are dropping an iron nail there in copper sulfate solution, iron plus copper sulfate, you know what is the color of copper sulfate solution? Yes, as you said, it is blue in color. Copper sulfate solution is blue color. So you know the solution is blue in color, and that pure iron nail we are dropping the, and iron nail is silvery gray color. You know that silvery gray color of iron nail, silvery gray. So silvery gray colored iron nail we are dropping into the blue colored copper sulfate solution. After a few hours, the reaction will be taking place, and what is happening, the iron sulfate will be produced there, and copper will be deposited there. Iron sulfate plus copper. So the color will change from blue to green color. Green color. Green is the color of iron sulfate there, and the color of the solution will change from blue to green, and copper is reddish brown color. Reddish brown or brown color. Copper will be in that color. That you know, pure copper is having copper wire for electrical purposes we are using. So the color of the copper is brown there, and this will be the color change after that reaction. So in a particular reaction, any type of color change is observed there, clearly we can tell that a chemical reaction or a chemical change has taken place there. If it is a chemical change, definitely we can say that a chemical reaction has taken place. So first of all, if there is a change in color, definitely in a particular chemical reaction, we can say that a chemical reaction has taken place there. Okay, then one more example, we can see that burning of magnesium ribbon there. Burning of magnesium ribbon at that time, burning of magnesium ribbon. When magnesium is burned, magnesium actually it is available as a ribbon. Okay, is a metal strip, we will get it as a metal strip. And that metal strip, before burning, we have to clean it using a sandpaper. Because you know that magnesium is a reactive metal, and that magnesium, when we kept it without any reaction there for some time, that magnesium usually forms an oxide coating of magnesium oxide, which will inhibit the reaction further. So without cleaning, if you are trying to burning, it will not burn, or it will take long time to burn. Okay, so before burning that magnesium ribbon, we have to clean it using sandpaper to remove the magnesium oxide coating. And if you are burning that magnesium ribbon, what is happening, we have to burn it in a spirit lamp or a burner. At that time, magnesium reacts with the oxygen. Magnesium reacts with oxygen, and at that time a dazzling white light will be, dazzling white light will be produced. how we are when we are burning that fireworks and all, at that time the dazzling white light, you might have observed it. Same dazzling white light will be observed the when magnesium is burned, ribbon is burned in oxygen. And after burning, what we are getting is a white ash, and that white ash is of magnesium oxide. If you are burning magnesium, magnesium oxide white ash will be obtained. White ash of magnesium oxide will be obtained there. And this nature of magnesium oxide, as it is metal oxide, it is basic in nature, and in 8th standard we have studied how to prove that nature of magnesium oxide. That is, magnesium oxide, we can mix it with the water, small quantity, 2-3 drops of water, and we can dip a litmus paper which is red in color. If you are dipping that, it will change into blue color, and we can say that magnesium oxide is basic in nature. Okay, so it's a change the, and in this case lot of heat and light energy will be liberated. The magnesium burning, brilliant white light will be produced there, and a new material is produced there. Okay, and another, this is an example of a chemical reaction. Another example for a particular observable color change, there we can see when lead nitrate, it is obtained in crystal form or salt form. We can dissolve it in water, and lead nitrate solution will be obtained there. And that lead nitrate solution, we can mix it with a potassium iodide. When lead nitrate is mixed with the potassium iodide, at that time we will get lead iodide. Iodide plus potassium nitrate, lead iodide plus potassium nitrate, and this lead iodide is yellow colored precipitate. During this reaction, yellow colored material will be precipitated. Both these are clear solution, and these two solutions, when we are mixing it together, at that time we are getting a new yellow colored solution, and after some time that color will be settling down at the bottom, and we can say that a yellow precipitate of lead iodide is produced there. And this is a chemical change or chemical reaction in which a color change is observed. Okay, then next case we can see that, first we have seen that if there is a color change, we can say that a chemical reaction has taken place. Then secondly, we can say that a gas, sometimes there may be evolution of a gas. There will be evolution. A gas will be evolved there. Gas is evolved. Evolution of a gas is there in a particular chemical change. At that time, there also we can say that a chemical reaction has taken place. For example, if you are dropping zinc metal piece, small bits of zinc metal piece, we will get it, that we can call it as zinc granule. And if you are dropping that zinc granules in dilute sulfuric acid or hydrochloric acid, any acid we can select, and that metal, if you are dropping into that acid, a gas is evolved. Brisk effervescence will be there, and that gas is of hydrogen. How can you say that the evolved gas is hydrogen? For that test is there. If you are showing a burning matchstick there into the mouth of the test tube in which the reaction is happening, that matchstick burns with a pop sound, then we can say that evolved gas is hydrogen. So in this case, if it is a hydrochloric acid, zinc chloride will be produced there. with the hydrogen gas. So this is the example of an evolution of a gas. And if it is sulfuric acid, zinc sulfate plus hydrogen gas. And this reaction is a exothermic reaction. Exothermic reaction means a reaction in which heat energy is evolved out. During a particular reaction, energy is evolved out. Then that reaction is known as exothermic reaction. So this is an exothermic reaction. After the reaction, the test tube will be very hot. If you are touching the bottom of the test tube, we can feel it. Okay, so in this case, there will be energy changes. So if a gas is evolved, then that time also we can say that a chemical reaction has taken place. And another case we can say that change in physical state, that is always possible, change in physical state. Physical state means appearance of solid, liquid and gas. In this case also, this is solid and this is liquid, and this is again, this is soluble case. So this is as a liquid we are getting. Zinc chloride will be soluble, so that we are getting the, and then hydrogen, this is in the gaseous form. So physical state also will change if a chemical reaction is happening. So once again, sometimes there will be a change in color, sometimes there will be a change in physical state, and sometimes there will be an evolution of a gas. Then sometimes there will be a formation of a precipitate that we have seen in the case of lead nitrate and potassium iodide. There a formation of a precipitate is there, that was yellow colored potassium lead iodide, yellow color, that is a precipitate. So in the particular reaction, if a precipitate is formed, then also we can say that a chemical reaction has taken place. Okay. Then if any temperature changes, that time also we can say that a chemical reaction has taken place. As per this case, this temperature change will be the, as this particular reaction is an exothermic reaction, energy is evolved out. So the temperature will be changing, that time also we can say that this is a chemical change in which temperature is changing. Change in temperature will be there. Okay, so if these observation, among these observation, any one is observed there, then that particular reaction or that particular change we can call it as a chemical reaction. Change in color, change in temperature, formation of a precipitate, evolution of a gas, or the change in physical state of the materials. Okay, this chemical reactions are represented by chemical equations. We can see chemical equations. Chemical equations. Chemical reactions are represented by chemical equations, and that chemical equations we can write in two ways, either as word equation or symbol equation. If that chemical equation we are writing it as, suppose magnesium reacts with oxygen, if you are writing it as magnesium plus oxygen, writing in words, oxygen reacts, reaction we are showing as arrow which is headed towards the product side. What we are getting new, that is actually known as the product, and what is undergoing reaction, they are known as reactants. Chemical reaction, materials undergoing chemical reaction known as reactants, and which we are getting as new, that is magnesium oxide is product. Okay, so the reactants and products will be the in a chemical reaction, chemical equation, and if more than one reactants are the separated by plus sign, and product also if more than one is the, that also will be separated by plus sign, and both the reactants and products are separated by an arrow. So once again concluding, we can say that chemical changes are also known as chemical reactions. And if that changes among the given changes, any one is observed, then we can say that a chemical reaction has taken place. For example, there is if there is a color change, if there is an evolution of a gas, if there is a change in temperature, and if there is a formation of a precipitate or physical status changing, then we can definitely, without any doubt, we can say that a chemical reaction has taken place. Thank you.